Welcome to Gimme a Break, the only programme that turns the family holiday upside down by giving the kids total control. On Gimme a Break, the kids have all the say. They decide where they go, what activities they do, and most importantly, they're in charge of the holiday rules. So let's see which lucky family are about to go on a break unlike any they've ever had before. Meet the Sandhus. There's 13-year-old Simra, 11-year-old Parminder, 8-year-old Monika, Action Man Dad, and Chill Out Queen Mum. So, why do these girls deserve a break?
Most of the time we go camping, but we don't really call that a holiday, but our parents do.
He doesn't like sitting down, I don't like doing things.
Mum and Dad have two completely different ideas of what they'd rather do on holiday. Mum would go lie on the beach, whereas Dad would go hiking up a mountain.
And when we go on a family holiday, it's just the same. Camping, camping, camping.
It's boring.
When they've been around 40 years, they can complain.
One of the most frustrating things about Dad is him and his gadgets.
I absolutely love gadgets.
He sits down in his little camp chair with his mates sitting next to him. They get out their phones and they're just like, oh, we should get that laptop. No, that phone.
When we're on holiday, it's not just us. We've also got loads of family.
I think it would make a really big difference if it was just the five of us.
If we took over the family holiday, we'd show Mum and Dad how to have a really good time.
Because we're kids, we know what we like.
Oh dear, I think these girls are definitely well deserving of a proper family break. Anyway, are you ready to call the shots?
Yes!
There's only one way to do it. It's the parent promise. Can you please put your hands on hearts and read that out loud and proud?
We the parents of Simran, Parminder and Monika hand over control of the family break.
Woo! You happy?
Yes!
Whilst you have all of the power, we need to have a bit of a chin wag. Come on.
Ladies, what sort of things do you want from your break?
Something adventurous.
Thrills and excitement without the theme park.
Action type stuff. How are you going to get Mum involved in the plan?
A simple thing called a rule.
I like the attitude. High five for that. Armed with all that info, I've set up three cracking holidays for the girls to choose from. However, they'll need to decipher my cunning clues to try and work out what's on offer. Starting with break number one.
Oh, I see clothes. I see wellies.
Simran, please take a look around to find a castle that you must climb.
Loch Ness Monster.
Scotland.
Wow, these girls are quick. But what about the funny clothes?
This suit. It looks proper old, like something my granddad would wear.
It's got that shaker pattern of Scotland thing.
I think it's a Scottish hat because it's kind of like got Scottish patterns on it.
I see something in that climbing
thing.
Look,
it's a wing.
Oh, wow. Simran had to go and climb up the castle. The first clue we got was this weird wig thing. We had no idea what it was.
It feels weird.
Like horse hair.
Seal. Second clue was a toy of a little baby seal with binoculars.
Or what if we was on a boat looking out for baby seals?
Yes, spot on.
I just don't get this.
Oh, well, they nearly got it all. Let's see how they do with break number two.
It's a dragon.
We found this dragon and it was guarding a clue. And there was this blindfold, so Bummy put on the blindfold.
Okay.
And turned to the right, and we had to guide her around the dragon to get to the clue. Looking forward to I tell you to stop. Careful, careful. Okay, he's up a bit. There. Careful. Careful!
Oh, I feel something.
Yippee!
Will your parents survive this boat rape?
What's the significance of this dragon?
Careful, guys. You're going to wake him up.
Whales! There's a, on the flag, there's a dragon, isn't there? A red dragon.
Yeah!
I did warn them.
Hop around and you will see some other clues as to what this break might be.
And she's off and already found the first clue.
Either leeks or spring onions.
I think they're leeks.
Spring onions.
Leeks!
You're almost there, Monika.
Is that all? Yeah.
Come on,
Monika! Fish face!
We have one big fish, one little fish, there's a boat.
We had a shepherd and then we had a fish. So I think that we might be fishing as well as cooking the fish and we might be doing it in whats.
They're doing really well, but how will they get on with final break number three?
Look, I see balloons.
I see balloons.
It's a give me a breaky thing.
You'll all have
Craking time
on this wet and wild break.
Anyone know anywhere called Crake?
That's orange.
Green,
that's green.
And white,
that's white.
Colours of a flag?
No. Could be.
That's right, but of which country?
Maybe. Oh, goodness.
Boxing gloves!
We went to the water, we found boxing gloves, we found baseball bat, and we found a football. Because we found them in water, we were doing water sports.
Correct again, but what about that destination?
Brazil!
Brazil! So we could be going to Brazil doing water sports.
So guys, how did you find the clues that I set you?
Frustrating.
Break number one, where do you think it is?
Scotland.
Have a look.
You'll be swapping campsites for a castle on this amazing Scottish break. There'll be seal spotting aboard a high-speed boat, an exhilarating high rope course, and you'll even meet some local farm animals. Mum will have no time to relax on this coast and castle adventure.
So, what do you think?
I think it's really cool. This is something that even Mum might join in with.
Break number two. Where do you think that might be?
Yeah, Wales.
What might you be doing?
Fishing.
Yeah. And then cooking it along with spring onions.
Well, yeah. I can tell you they weren't spring onions, they were leeks.
I was right, I told you!
Number two is a cool canal boat break in Wales.
Oh, cool.
We was right again.
You'll be travelling and staying on this beautiful canal boat and be jumping ashore for some gorge walking, rock climbing and abseiling. You'll also learn how to herd sheep and attempt to catch your own lunch.
Your thoughts, please?
It's pretty cool. Really, really cool.
Onwards, break number three.
We were sure that it was Brazil.
Not Brazil. Break number three is an action-packed water sports adventure in Ireland.
On this wet and wild Irish break, you'll be sailing, kayaking, and even building your own raft. With an adventure course and Irish dancing thrown in, this is sure to be an amazing family break. To be sure!
I don't think Mum will like any of the breaks we've been given, which is a good thing. That means that's what we want.
Is this going to be a really difficult decision?
Yeah.
I'll leave you to it.
The coolest one, personally, is the canal boat one.
I like the Wales one too. What about you, Monique?
I like Scotland the best because you get to stay in the castle.
We haven't said anything about Ireland.
Ireland's way out for me. Yeah. Way out.
The Wales one looks really cool.
I do really like Scotland. Mm.
It's cool.
We've decided. What about you?
You guys are taking forever. Which break are you going to go on?
Scotland.
Scotland. Consider it booked. I'm going to pop back up during your break, see how you're getting on, and offer you the chance to win one final treat.
Dun, 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 dun.
If you pass, the treat is yours, but if you fail,
dun, dun, dun.
Mum and Dad get it.
No!
So the Sandhus are off to Scotland, but how will Mum cope with all the activities? And who will win that final treat?
So let the girls pack for me and Mum. Not too sure about that.
They're always complaining about me being in black, so I think they're just going to pack my colourful stuff.
Mum will hate this. It's going in.
I might have to do a little sneaky to see how they're actually doing.
I've got a feeling I'm going to be living in what I'm wearing for the next few days.
Good job, ladies. So with suitcases packed, there's nothing left to do but get in the car and head off to the airport. Once they arrive, the girls have one last little surprise to see if Mum and Dad can guess where they're going.
Nasty. Sort of mouldy cheese, isn't it?
Nice.
It's not one of your dad's socks, is it?
Now try and taste it to see if that helps.
Some kind of meat.
Yeah.
Germany.
No. Take off your blindfolds now. It was haggis. It's a Hoston Castle adventure in Scotland.
I'm going to Scotland.
I was hoping for a nice sandy beach, somewhere really nice and warm, and instead I get rainy Scotland.
Where are you going today?
Scotland. I think our parents were a bit disappointed when they found out we were going to Scotland.
I'm all right with it. I'll give it a go, see what we got.
I'll give it a go, but I'm not all right with it.
Enjoy your flight.
I'll give them a 7 to 8.
Me, I think I'd give them a 2, only because they're staying in a castle.
I think once we get started, they'll love it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, they were right. Mum was always going to be hard to please. But I've got a feeling that Scotland may just throw up a few surprises. A short plane ride and a shorter drive later, and they're in Ullapool, on the west coast of Bonnie Scotland, a country famous for its lochs and castles. The family finally arrive at their coastal cottage, and the girls are eager to pick their rooms out.
This is mine.
This is mine.
However, Mum and Dad are more eager to pick through the contents of the suitcases.
Oh, boxers, excellent.
My main concern was that they weren't packing enough underwear.
I'm looking for my underwear, girls.
And I was right.
I found one pair so far.
Not looking good.
Only one pair of underpants. Bit gutted about that. Mark's out of 10 for packing. I'm going to give them 7. I'm surprised, but there you go.
Well, I think they did me quite well, so I'll give them an 8.
So a general thumbs up to you girls. Well
Yay!
Done.
High five.
It's day one of the break, and nothing like a good brekkie to prepare yourself for the day ahead, especially as it kicks off with those dreaded rules.
Hello, Sandhu family.
Hi.
So I hope you're all settled in and enjoying the start of your break, but it is now time to find out those all-important rules. Mum, Dad, are you ready?
Let's have it.
First of all, Dad, the girls are tired of your obsession with gadgets. So, rule number one, there will be no gadgets or anything to do with gadgets at any time during the break.
Like it.
An injustice.
Next, I've just got to take this call, Dad. Hang on. Hello. Ha, actually, there's no one there. I just wanted to remind you what you've been missing, Dad. So, on to rule number 2, and this one's for you, Mum. You have to take part in every activity, no matter what it is. So that means no sneaking off to relax and read your magazines.
Oh, no! I love sitting and reading my magazine.
Sorry, Mum, but them's the rules. On to rule number 3, you are not allowed to nag the kids about anything ever.
Yes!
I'm your mother, it's my job to nag you.
Now, finally, remember, if any of these rules are broken, there will be consequences. You have been warned. I'll be back towards the end of your break to fill you in on the details about that final treat. In the meantime, enjoy yourselves. See ya!
Bye!
Yay!
I think the rules are terrible. I think the rules are an injustice to my humanity, a travesty.
With the rules out of the way, the break can finally begin. And the girls are kicking things off in style.
Okay, girls, we're in Ullapool Harbour, so what are we doing here?
We thought we'd start this break off with a nice high-energy rib ride.
Okay, kids, what is a rib ride?
That's a rib ride!
Oh, that's fast, man!
Mum's gonna absolutely hate it because her face said it all.
I am really nervous. If this is how we're starting our holiday, I'm scared to think about what we're gonna do with the rest of it.
I'll expect it to be quite choppy and I expect to get very wet.
You're not wrong there, Dad.
Love it, great.
I'd rather be at home having a cup of tea.
Cheer up, Mum. The weather may not be the best, but that doesn't stop a visit from some friendly faces.
Really, what I think they are, they're seals.
We found them!
Yes, four.
after a successful seal search, the family get one final blast of some high-speed rib action and head back to shore.
It's nice that we're all together because we hardly do any activities together.
Mum said it was wicked!
For the first activity, this is a rip-roaring start, that's sure.
It's the second day of the break, and after yesterday's exertions, the family head off for some farm activities. You know, hanging out with cute animals and stuff. So, surely things will be more to Mum's liking.
You know, I'm not an animal person or a goldfish person.
You've never tried it, though.
And a dog. I have a dog phobia as well. Well, I'll give it a go, that's all I'll do.
You have to give it a go, Mum. Remember the rules.
Right, these chicks are about 3 weeks old. So if you guys want to pick them up and hold them, keep its wings with under your hand like that and just hold it gently and then it can't fly away.
They've got the little comb on their head, so that's like the cockerel's comb.
Come on, Mum. It's your turn now.
You just put your one hand flat like that. And then just put the other hand gently over its wings and keep it like a palm.
Mum, you did it!
It's not
See, it's not that bad. After that, Mum starts to enjoy life on the farm.
You got one!
Well, sort of.
Get him up, please.
To finish off, they go to feed Jock the horse.
Why? It's him!
Keep your hand nice and flat and put your hand out like that. There you go.
Sorry! Got some carrots.
Hang on, what's Dad up to? So sneaky, but has anyone spotted him?
Thank you very much for coming down to visit us.
Daddy, what is in your pocket?
It's tissue, see?
Yes, but I saw you on your phone.
I have a real phone.
Dad!
Well done, Monica. And I warned you there'd be a consequence, Dad. So get mocking those pigs out.
This is what happens when you got
new... You broke the rules.
I can't trust my own children.
From farming, it's on to fishing. And with a barbecue later that evening, the family will have to try and catch something for their dinner.
This is going to be funny. Just look at them trying to get their waders on, first of all.
These are absolutely massive for me!
And what we've got here is a typical trout fishing rod.
So, after a short demo, they each step up to give it a go.
Forward, keep the thumb on the top. Forward. Yeah.
That's actually more fun than I thought it would be.
Time's running out, guys. I think a team effort is required if you're going to catch anything. So the family wait and wait and wait some more. But nothing seems to be biting today. No luck at the lock then, and with food still needed for the barbecue, they move on to a bit of mussel collecting.
You don't want to pick the really small ones.
Lines.
Yeah, that's a good size, okay? You just pull it off. Brilliant.
With a healthy haul, Rosie first teaches the family how to clean the mussels.
That's what attaches them to the rocks, and it's known as their beard. So we're going to pull that off. There we go, Kim.
Done it!
And finally, how to shell a prawn.
No. Take it apart and then gently just pull. There you go, there's a lovely prawn ready to eat.
I've never cracked open a prawn or done anything like that because we get it ready-made from the shop always.
I've really enjoyed this beach barbecue, it's been lovely. I've shelled a prawn for the first time. Normally I can't eat anything with eyes pointing at me.
Can I eat this?
You eat them.
It's just been the five of us. It's been very enjoyable and it's definitely something we'd consider doing again.
I'm having a great time. Don't tell the kids that.
After a good night's rest, the family are ready for more action, and it's time to find out what the girls have in store next.
Any guesses?
I don't know. Treetop climbing, falling off a bridge.
We're going to do a high rope course.
What's that?
Well, Mum, first there's a 50-foot abseil into a gorge, followed by a rock climb across the treacherous cliff face, and then you'll end with a huge zip line over the river. Phew! If you're gonna face that, you'll need to be harnessed up first. The daunting abseil awaits, and Monica bravely steps up first.
I'm actually, like, kind of, like, a little bit scared and a little bit excited at the same time.
Well done. Oh, good stuff.
Well done, Monica.
Excellent. Well done, lass.
Well done, Nikki.
Yay! Excellent.
One down, four to go.
Look, I don't think she's going to go.
But back at the top, someone's already starting to feel the pressure.
I think she's going to cry.
There we go.
That's scary.
Good job, well done.
One by one, they all make it down.
Little baby steps left. Baby steps.
Until finally, it's Mum's turn. Will she be able to do it?
I'm scared.
I really am.
That's the one. Brilliant, that's beautiful. Last, that's the hardest bit you've just done. Okay? Keep looking at me. Oh, yeah? You're doing great.
Come on, Mum! You can do it!
That's it.
Come on, Mum! You did it, Mum!
Okay.
How was that?
That was really, really, really good. Well done.
I can't explain it. I've never felt terror like it ever.
Phew, I wasn't sure she was going to make it. But despite overcoming that tough start, the hard work continues with the rock climbing.
The worst thing was the climbing, because every 2 minutes I kept losing my grip and I had to rely on the rope a lot, and I don't like relying on rope.
On parts of the course, the family had to work together, or you couldn't get around it. And it was a good learning curve for the family, I think.
And to finish off, it's that thrilling zip wire across the river.
Arms out, screaming. OK.
Go, 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 go!
Go, 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 go!
Let's just get over and done with, mate. Give me a push, go on.
A big push. Stand up. Brilliant.
I'm really glad we did this because everyone enjoyed themselves, even Mum did.
As a family, we kind of pulled together and we did it and got through it all.
Team Sandhu!
Exhilarated, the family make one final journey to the castle, where they'll complete their coast and castle adventure.
When we first arrived at this castle, I thought, we're not staying here, surely. I mean, it is beautiful.
Yay. Welcome, Sandhu family. We brought you here to have a Highland dancing masterclass. Before we get started, I have a special treat for Mum and Dad.
A special treat? Oh, we'll see. Check out those kilts.
What do you think, guys?
Before the kilts can be put to good use, the family get a demo of how it should be done. Right, fam, let's see what you've got.
And you just kick over, and then the other side, and then you kick over and you face this way, and then you turn round.
The Highland dancing was confusing, and it was also, it looked easy, but it was actually really hard because you had to get your feet right and all that. I have honestly never seen my parents wearing kilts before, never seen Mum in a skirt, and obviously I've never seen Dad in a skirt, that would just be weird.
To finish things off in traditional Scottish style, the family sit down for an end-of-break haggis dinner. And to keep with tradition, the head of the family toasts the haggis and dishes it out.
This one smells so much better than that nasty thing at the airport, doesn't it?
Mmm, it tastes so good.
I have to say, I've enjoyed this much more than I thought I would.
Here's to some more Team Sandhu holidays in the future.
So this Scottish break is finally coming to an end. But before the family head home, there's still that final treat to play for.
Hello!
Sandhus.
Hi.
I hope you've all had an amazing break. However, the fun isn't over yet because there is one final treat on offer and it's a thrilling helicopter ride.
Oh my God, yeah, we got it!
Right, guys, if you're going to win this, you need to answer two out of the next three questions correctly. Get two right and the chopper ride is yours. However, if you get two out of three wrong, Mum and Dad will be snatching that treat away from you. Question number one. Which activity was Mum most surprised about that she enjoyed? Was it A, fly fishing, or B, farm activities?
I think it's a farm activity because, you know, she said she quite enjoyed it and she hates animals.
But fly fishing, she said that she enjoyed
it. Yeah, and she never said she was surprised that she enjoyed it.
Okay, so going with B?
B.
Yeah. B.
Yeah.
So what's your final answer, girls?
Yeah.
B.
B.
You're going B, farm activities. Right, let's see what Mum said.
The activity that I was most surprised that I enjoyed was fly fishing.
Oh! Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hard luck, girls. Well, you have to get this next one right now to be in with a chance of winning that treat. What one word did Dad use to describe the haggis at the airport? Was it A, disgusting, or B, horrible?
Ooh, it was disgusting.
No, horrible. Dad would never say disgusting, he'd just say horrible.
Okay. No, are you sure? Mum said it was disgusting.
Dad said it tasted familiar.
I can't imagine him saying, oh, that's disgusting.
Just take a guess. If they get it, they get it.
I need an answer, please.
B. Horrible.
Let's find out.
The haggis at the airport was disgusting.
No!
I said it was
I'm so excited about the helicopter ride. I've never been on a helicopter before, so I can't wait.
Charlie, got a training requirement today to do a POR approach.
Wow, this is fantastic. This is absolutely beautiful.
Right, looking 1-1 for Apple Ankle.
Wow, look at that.
Fantastic. I think this break will change the next family holiday into just completely chilling out because Mum and Dad are so tired.
I'm going to be more inclined to want to do things that the kids want to do.
I'm so looking forward to getting back to my gadgets.
Get ready for Comic Relief Does Glee Club.
Fantastic.
We've scoured the country to find the UK's best young performing group. We've auditioned thousands to find the best choir, musical theatre and contemporary acts to battle it out live for your votes. So, who will you crown the winners of Comic Relief Does Glee Club 2011?
Continues today at 5:15 on BBC One.
Get ready to vote.